The soaring demand for energy and fuel sources has caused great exploitation of fossil-based resources. This great exploitation has caused great concerns environmentally, sociopolitically, and also economically. So there's a great search for decades to find alternative renewable sources to replace these fossil-based energy and fuel sources. Road transport is one of the main contributors to greenhouse gas emissions. So there is always the thought that let's find a way, let's find a solution to go towards cars or vehicles that can use biofuels instead, hydrogen and electricity. Ethanol is one of the most famous biofuels that has been studied for long in order to replace fossil fuels. The first generation bioethanols are produced from starch and sugary-based material, for example, corn or sugarcane or wheat here in Sweden. Although the process is well matured and it's rather simple and it's commercialized, but the substrate or the feedstock that is used for production of this type of bioethanol has always had this ethical issue with the fact that this type of material, this type of feedstock, could be used as human food and animal feed. Second generation bioethanol is produced from lignocellulosic material, which are such as wood chip and wheat straw, forest residues or agricultural residues. These type of feedstock are cheap, they are abundant, and they don't compete with human food and animal feed. However, production of bioethanol from these is very difficult. The process is complicated and the technology is not advanced in that regard. So there are different problems associated with production of lignocellulosic bioethanol. So by the help of membranes in this thesis, I have tried to tackle those issues and technically and economically improve the process in order to find ways for the lignocellulosic bioethanol to have more share in the market of bioethanol and replace the first generation bioethanol that is produced from food and feed grade material. Membranes and membrane separation technology and membrane bioreactors, they have been long used in water and wastewater treatment. However, now we are taking that technology of membranes, membrane separation, and merging that with production of biofuels. Now in this case is bioethanol. So now it's going from filtration and clarification and production of clean water to producing a valuable compound that can be used as a fuel, bioethanol here. The process that we developed between the years 2015 and 2019 for using the membrane bioreactors for production of bioethanol, now we have taken that method and we are applying that for production of valuable chemicals. The input material to this membrane bioreactor are organic waste, for example, food waste, okay? And by the help of the membrane bioreactor, we produce valuable chemicals instead of biogas that have higher market value and market appeal, such as acetic acid that is used in vinegar. By using lignocellulosic bioethanol instead of bioethanol produced on sugary and starchy material, we are targeting different sustainable development goals. We are fighting climate change, we are providing affordable and clean energy, and also fighting hunger.